Biodiesel is a renewable fuel alternative to petroleum diesel. A 2011 published report co-authored by researchers from the University of Idaho and the USDA, entitled Energy Life Cycle Assessment of Soybean Biodiesel Revisited, also found that for every unit of fossil energy needed to produce biodiesel, it returns a stunning 5.54 units of renewable energy. This energy in, energy out ratio is called energy balance or fossil energy ratio. Biodiesel derived from soybeans, for example, benefits from free energy from the sun. The study also compared biodiesel with other fuels such as liquefied propane, natural gas, electricity, and gasoline. The objective of the study was to construct an updated biodiesel energy life cycle inventory with the 2006 data of soybean production and biodiesel plants built after 2002. Additionally, a comparison of the three time periods from past studies conducted in 1990, 2002, and 2006 indicated how energy life cycles change over time. The US DOE and USDA completed the first comprehensive life cycle analysis for biodiesel production back in 1998. That study found a 3.2 to 1 energy balance. The energy inventory for this study was updated in 2009 using 2002 data, which found that the ratio had improved to 4.56 to 1. Specifically, the 2011 study found three critical factors that led to the leap in biodiesel's energy balance number. First, newer data from the USDA equipment manufacturers and the industry indicate that soybean crushing facilities and biodiesel plants have become increasingly more energy efficient over the years. Second, soybean farmers have adopted energy-saving farm practices such as minimum tillage. Third, overall yields of soybeans have increased. In comparison to the 2009 study, the new study found the energy input in soybean agriculture was reduced by 52%. The energy input in soybean processing was reduced by 58%. And the energy input in biodiesel production was reduced by 33%. Overall, the energy input reduction was 42% for an equal amount of biodiesel produced. The addition of secondary inputs, such as farm machinery and building materials, did not have a significant effect on the fossil energy ratio. The study found that soybean growers greatly improved yields because of new seed varieties, improved fertilizer and pesticide applications, and new management practices. Genetically engineered soybeans, in particular, had a significant impact. According to the study, genetically engineered soybeans have increased yields through their reduced pesticide use and costs with herbicide-tolerant and pest management traits. Results of the study suggest fossil energy ratio of 5.54 for biodiesel will continue improving in the coming years. Researchers expect soybean yield to increase over time, and the biodiesel industry is likely to continue to increase energy efficiencies, which will eventually contribute to a higher fossil energy ratio. Also, the possible replacement of fossil fuel with renewable fuel, like biodiesel use in farm equipment, could also significantly improve biodiesel fossil energy ratio over time. The entire publication is available on the Biodiesel Education website.